Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at using Siri to send and receive text messages on your iPhone. So sometimes I'm asked if I really use Siri, and I say, sure I do, all the time. And then I tell them how, and they confess they didn't even know Siri could do this. You see, with Siri, it's easy to read a text message and reply to a text message without ever having to look at or tap your screen. Matter of fact, you can leave your iPhone in your pocket. For instance, when I'm biking, I have my headphones on, I'm listening to an audiobook or music, and I can hear that a text message comes in, I can ask Siri to read it to me, and then I can reply to it without ever even breaking stride. So let's say I'm riding along and I get a text message. Now, here's the screen of my iPhone, but my iPhone's in my pocket. I've got my headphones in, and so I can hear when a text message comes and I can reply to it using the microphone in the headphones. So I hear that sound and I'll then use the microphone on my headphones to ask Siri, read me that message.
You have a message from Joe Smith. Are we meeting for lunch today? You can reply or read it again.
Reply.
What do you want to say to Joe Smith?
Yes, see you at noon.
I updated your message. Ready to send it?
Yes.
Okay, I'll send it.
So the key, of course, is using the headphones. And with the button here and the microphone on it, I can reply just using the microphone here, and usually just by letting it hang while you're walking or riding. It picks up your voice just fine and you can use Siri that way. You could also use this to initiate text messaging. So you want to message somebody, you can simply bring your hand up and press and hold for a second or so, and then you'll hear the little Siri tone and you can start a text message conversation that way. Send a text message to Joe Smith.
What do you want to say to Joe Smith?
Can we meet for lunch tomorrow instead?
I updated your message. Ready to send it?
Yes.
Okay, I'll send your message.
Now Siri can also do things in different ways. So for instance, a really quick shortcut to be able to send a text message to somebody is just do it as one command. Tell Joe Smith I'll be there soon.
Here's your message to Joe Smith. Ready to send it?
Yes. For this to work best, you want to make sure your contacts are good. You go into your contacts and, for instance, make sure, of course, that either their phone number for text messaging or their iMessages email address is there. And then also, when you edit, you can go down to Add Field and then make sure maybe do a phonetic first name and phonetic last name if Siri has trouble understanding you when you say their name, or add a nickname that you can call them and Siri will understand that nickname. So for instance, you can add say wife for your wife, and then you can say send a text message to my wife. And of course we can debate whether or not this is safe or not, or whether it violates some state's texting while driving laws. But if you're listening to your iPhone already while driving in the car and you have it connected either via Bluetooth or a USB connection, you can use Siri to read a text message you just got in, which could give you a clue whether or not it's important enough to pull over and answer the text message then, or simply wait until you get to your destination to answer the text message. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.